Hey there, everybody. My name is Turtle. Welcome back to MotorStorm Pacific Rift. Today, we're going to be going four more races in the festival, starting with the Earth soon, as per usual. First up is Razorback, Missing Links, with a buggy or a rally car. Okay, so it took me some thought, but I think I'm actually going to use a rally car here, because I just want to go fast down that one very long downhill section, because it's just so fun to do. But I want to use one I don't typically use to make it harder. So let's use this, the Italian feature, I mean. Let's use the green skin too. I can never use this car. Alright. Razorback, the daddy, mud, dirt, flora, caves, rock, water. Deadly drop-offs, dangerous jumps, spectacular falls, and fast-flowing rivers. This is the big one. The whole MotorStorm ethos showcased in a single epic track. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, your time to shine is now. This track is great, by the way. I love this track. It's such a good track. Like, it works well with every vehicle. It doesn't really matter what you use. It's got lines for everything, and all of them are about equal. It's like the Grizzly from MotorStorm Monument Valley, but new for Pacific Rift. I suddenly remembered why I don't like this rally car as much. It's got such a weird camera angle. Look at that. Just sitting right on top of the car. Just standing on the back bumper, like, holding the camera. Gotta admit, though, rally cars are fast. Love rally cars. They're probably my favorite vehicle in the game. It's a real toss-up between rally cars and bikes as to which one's my actual favorite, but I don't know, man. Rally cars, just for the sheer speed of them, there's just no beating them. They reward the skilled hand and punish the one who doesn't know what he's doing. I think I'm going to nail that target time, though. I don't think it's going to be much of an issue. I forgot to mention that was up there, the 425 in the corner. Let's go for a shortcut. Uh-oh. I knew that as soon as I hit that bump, I was dead. Oh, man. That bump is death. Whew. You see how well I stuck right there? It usually didn't happen with rally cars. That was weird. Ooh, that was a good one, though. Man, that was a really good one, though. I might actually have to try to speedrun this track with this car. I don't know that I've ever tried it with this car. It'd be interesting to see if I can break records with it. It's doing pretty well. That was a really bad turn, but... Hey, pal. I can honk, too. We're just both in a honk war at the moment. This guy's just holding the horn down. Blaring it like a New York taxi cab. I'm not holding the button. The horn no longer works. I think I actually broke my horn just now. I've never seen that happen before. The horn just stopped working and it just stuck until it petered out. Yeah, the horn no longer does anything. It's just gone. Okay. It shows again. I'm not hit that bump this time. Yeah, see right there? See how the way you're stuck to the ground instead of popping into the air? And that is how you do it. That is quick. That was a good one. Nailed that again. This car's good on this track. I didn't figure the flat body that it has. You can see how flat it is. I figured that I could hit a rock or something and just shoot off the edge of the track, which is why I never tried it. But it's good. It's good on this track. Oh, the horn's back. Oh no. Is it gonna be like that old video? Probably not. Where are the AI? Holy smokes! That's a crazy lead, dude. Man, I blew them clear out of the water. They need to get good. Ooh, I got the speed ticket in the Earth Zone. Nice. What do we got in the air zone today? Badlands. Ashes to Ashes. Rect limit. Race. Rank 4. 2 laps. I had a terrible idea. Alright, we're going to use the Patriotic Wasabi Eagle. This might be the only time in the entire series you see me use this particular ATV. Badlands. A giant track. Racing at the feet of a giant cinder cone. Badlands has a name that's perfectly descriptive. Wait until you see the enormous active crater you need to jump over, or the blind sheer precipices you need to tear around at high speed if you're going to have any chance of winning. And let's not get into the collapsed tunnels. Man, dude, this track should not load this fast. It is huge. Like, look, I'm happy that they really optimized their game, but all I want to do is read the loading screen text, man. This track is absolutely huge, though. Of course, it's mostly a skybox, I believe. But still. But at least we got a banger of a song to listen to while I suffer on this ATP. Oh, man. Well, I'm not going to lie. Of all the tracks, this one is most suited for ATVs. Because there's no sharp turns, namely. But like, you see how the camera's off-center and stuff? It makes make no sense. The camera's always to the left. And then it switches to the right if you turn right long enough, but like, I'm not really sure why that's a thing. This guy's about to get whacked. Never mind, I got whacked because somehow my four-wheeler exploded. I got the worst respawn ever. Dude, ATVs just suck. Like, I know I've said that a lot, but like, that's proof right there. I didn't barely touch that guy, and my whole front end is just like, that's the end of that. I'm just dead now. Dude, it's just so bad. At least they're fast. Relatively speaking. Otherwise, this track, it's not bad with a four-wheeler. ATV, sorry. We call them four-wheelers here, if you're wondering. Like, four-wheeler, as in the number. Four-wheeler. Because, you know, they got four wheels. And, yeah, that sounds pretty redneck, because it is. That's what we call them. Some people call them quads, as well, which is just another word for four, and they think it's so much better. But I'm like, dude, it's four-wheeler or quad. They're both the same number. Like, ATV stands for, you know, all-terrain vehicle, which, honestly, that makes the most sense. So, ouch. That one was on me. I just smacked a rock. I'll be amazed if I actually win this first try with this thing. Normally, these races do not go smoothly with ATPs. Sitting right on the corner there. Oof. I'm trying to go straight for everything I'm worth. Things just sliding all over the place. I think the problem with them is they're so top heavy. If they lowered the center of gravity a bit to be more realistic, I think these things would handle properly. Oh, what? That was a perfect cut. And I got ripped off by an invisible wall. Oh well. At least it didn't count as a wreck, it just counted me out of bounds. I got beef with you. loser. You're your physics-defying back tire ripping apart my tie rods. Okay. Okay. Always appreciated those falling rocks back there, like the ones that skitter across the road. I always thought that was just a really nice touch for this track. Got it. With the wreck helmet. Not really great for as far as the skill level of racing that track was concerned, but it got me by, so we'll take it. Congratulations, you've just reached a new festival rank. I am now ranked 5. The part where the AI start to suck. And I got an Eliminator ticket in the air zone. With a new driver's pack that I still probably won't ever use. And I finally got all the cool vehicles. Like the ones that aren't any better than the other ones, but they're just cool. Like, here we go. In the fire zone, we have Paradise Beach, Ghost Town. Wreck limit of 2 wrecks. That's pretty tight. I'll run a buggy on this track, being that I ran a rally car earlier. But if I were to run one, I want it to be the Humbler Diablo with the black skin, because none of the other ones are nearly as cool. Paradise Beach. Paradise Beach was perfect. Clear skies, gentle surf, warm water. It was a small town, and the living was good. Was, that is, until 30 years ago when the fire god Pele cruised into town in his fiery hot rod of molten death and literally tore up the strip. Now all that remains is dust and bones. Welcome to paradise. Okay. Excuse me. Don't touch me. Leave me alone. I have a bull bar, I'll shove you off the road. That's what that thing in the front's called, right? You can't see it. That thing in the front? Or is it like a snowplow? What do you call that when it's a snowplow, but it's not for snow? It's made for hitting stuff. I call that a bull bar. But, I don't know. What does everybody else call that? Let me know. There goes the cover. Who needs it? Extra weight. Get rid of it. Did somebody already plow that sign? Oh, he did. That sign weighs a ridiculous amount. If you hit it, it's like hitting an 18-ton boulder. Like, that pole I just slammed into is more forgiving than that sign. Not really sure why that is either. That's how that rally car, the Lunatech Weevil, it slammed into it a minute ago, just exploded it into parts. It's because that sign has way too much weight. It's going to be hard to do, I'm not going to lie. Well, that guy tried to taunt me, so I tipped him. It's my loser. It's a terrible advice, right? How to deal with people who try to taunt you. Run them over. Not good advice in real life. In MotorStorm, it's the best advice you can get. Uh-oh. Okay. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. This is a whole bunch of bad. Am I wedged? Okay, I was gonna say, I thought I was wedged in between those two things. Just decided it was going to do a flip. Wanted to do a barrel roll. It's like, no, you got too lucky at that gas station a minute ago. We can't allow that, so we're just going to kill you by default. Whatever. I still won the race and got under the wreck limit. And got a shiny new car, because I respawned. Lethal Botchery just finished due. 4 seconds back. Not bad. With an ATV, too. Good work, man. I got the Eliminator ticket in the Fire Zone. Nice. The last race of this video is Beachcomber Coastline Run. I am absolutely going to use a rally car. There's no beating them on this track. So fun. Alright, let's use the Green Patriot Renegade, number 29. This is literally a NASCAR that they have converted to a dirt track car, which I don't think that would work at all, but, you know. Beachcomber, from an unassailable fortress high above Azure Pacific waters, battle is about to be joined. Take flight from an abandoned World War II airbase and engage the enemy over the beaches, along cliff tops, and through dense, dangerous jungle trails. Steer yourself for the conflict ahead. For those enemies, take no prisoners. Keep your foot down, cool your engines in the water, and something that I couldn't read because the loading screens are too fast. Alright. Ooh. I like how I have the Hothead logo up on top. I can't look at the camera down there. You see it? There you go. The planet logo on top of the car. That was really bad. But it worked. And I'm in first. And somehow I got a ram by accident right there. I bumped the button with my fat finger in it because I was trying to use the brake. Somebody just whammed the turret around twice. Also, it is my understanding at this time that no NASCAR or dirt track car has any glass in it because they take such a beating that the glass just shatters. So they remove the glass. They might use plastic instead. But I always thought that was weird, being that this thing looks like a NASCAR, or at least a really modified dirt track car, that it has glass in it. I always thought that was strange. Anyway, doesn't particularly matter. Also, if you're not familiar with dirt track circuit racing, just look it up. Look up dirt track racing. And it's pretty much just a big dirt oval, typically a quarter or half a mile if it's a long one. And they just have cars go pretty much as fast as they can around it, within reason. They do have to keep their cars together because they have so much torque. They do have so much torque that they will kill themselves, the cars, hopefully not the driver. So, yeah, look it up. It's a good time to watch. If you like this, you'll like that. I'm not sure if they do it in other parts of the world, though. So if you're not from the United States, let me know if you look up United States dirt track racing and you see that, let me know if that happens somewhere else. Specifically late models, by the way. If you're really getting into it, late models is what this reminds me of. Super lates. Late models, L-A-T-E, or super lates. They also have sprint cars, which are much faster, but have a giant wing on top of them and stuff. Might want to check that out too if you're looking into it. Anyway, enough about that. We're going to have a good time with the last few minutes, or the last few seconds actually, of this race here. Uh-oh. I might have to redo this race. Unless I was so far ahead that I still pulled this off somehow. What happened to the AI that they're that far behind? I had no right to win that. Or was I just gaming out of my mind and not even paying attention? I might have been. I don't know. That completes. Oh, never mind. We have a speed ticket in the water zone. Now, that completes this video. Thank you all so much for watching. My name is Turtle Dude. Peace out. 6 hours off on a road trip.